Your Subconscious Mind and Marital Problems, Chapter 9 from The Power of Your Subconscious Mind by Joseph Murphy. Let's jump right in. This really like this about marital problems or any relationship you're having. It's actually just really good in life lessons altogether. And good, there's a three-step formula in here. It can really be used for anything, but this is specifically for marital problems and relationship issues. Recently, a young couple married for a few months was seeking a divorce. I discovered that the young man had a constant fear that his wife would leave him. He expected rejection, and he believed that she would be unfaithful. These thoughts haunted him and became an obsession. His mental attitude was one of separation and suspicion. His own feeling of loss and separation operated through the relationship. This brought about a condition in accordance with the mental pattern behind it. His wife actually left home and asked for a divorce, which is what he feared and believed would happen. Divorce occurs first in the mind. All right, guys. Divorce occurs first in the mind. The legal proceedings follow. These two young people were full of resentment, fear, suspicion, and anger. These attitudes weaken and deliberate the whole being. The couple began to realize that they had been doing with their minds what they had... Okay, the couple began to realize what they had been doing with their minds. These two people returned together at my suggestion and experimented with prayer therapy, a method we will learn right here in this chapter. He brings this up. He does the prayer therapy. It's a little bit further down here. Each one practiced radiating to the other love, peace, harmony, health, and goodwill. They alternated in reading the Psalms every night. Their marriage began growing more beautiful every single day. Now, divorce is an individual problem. It cannot be generalized. In some cases, no marriage should have occurred to begin with. In other cases, divorce is not the solution. Divorce may be right for one person and wrong for another. A divorced woman may be far more sincere and noble than many of her married sisters who are perhaps living a lie. For couples that wish to stay together, the solution is to pray together. All right, guys, pray together. Here is a three-step program in prayer therapy. First, never carry over from one day to another accumulated irritations arising from little disappointments. Forgive each other for any sharpness before you retire at night. The moment you awaken, claim infinite intelligence in guiding you in all ways. Send out thoughts of peace, harmony, and love to your partner, to all family members, and to the entire world. Second, say grace at breakfast. Give thanks for the wonderful food, for your abundance, and for all your blessings. Make sure that no problems, worries, or arguments enter into the table conversation. The same applies at dinner time. Say to your partner, I appreciate all you are doing, and I radiate love and goodwill to you all day long. Third, spouses should alternate in praying each night. Do not take your marriage partner for granted. Show your appreciation and love. Think appreciation and goodwill rather than condemnation, criticism, and nagging. Before going to sleep, read the 23rd, 27th, and 91st Psalms, the 11th chapter of Hebrews, the 13th chapter of Corinthians, and other great texts of the Bible. As you practice these steps, your marriage will grow more blessed through the years. All right, guys, you probably want to write these down here. Before going to sleep, read these chapters, the 23rd, 27th, and 91st chapters of Psalms, and the 11th chapter of Hebrews, and the 13th chapter of 1 Corinthians. I really hope this chapter helps some relationships out there. I'm really, really hoping that people apply this if you're having any issues in your marriage or any relationships at that. This probably doesn't have to necessarily be a marriage, but it can be any kind of relationship. This would be helpful. All right, guys, this is Chapter 9, Your Subconscious Mind and Marital Problems. Thank you. Love you guys.